Good morning, or good afternoon, rather, to everyone out there. We got Cena Cup. We are going to be having a best of three between Vici Gaming and HGT, and we're just going to jump right into it because I actually want to talk about these two teams. So these two teams, Vici Gaming, are, in my opinion, the top team in China right now. They've been steamrolling through everyone. They've been looking so damn good. I mean, the Chinese qualifier finals, that was just a massacre. Right, Vici Gaming have just been creaming every single other Chinese team. That being said, HGT are one of the few teams that there was a lot of hype around them when they first came around pre-TI4. Everybody was like, oh my god, ZSMJ, that guy's such a legend, you know. And there was a lot of hype around this team, but they failed pretty badly. I mean, they really came short of what people were expecting of them. And now it seems like post-TI4 that we're getting a lot of shuffling going on in the Chinese scene. Many of these rosters are kind of unstable. We're still trying to figure out where the placement is right now. HGT have been looking really good in the last week and a half. They still had some troubles when we were first watching them in maybe some of the first few matches after TI4. HGT were... you know, still looking kind of rough. It was like, okay, they're still going to kind of be a tier two Chinese team. But in the last week and a half, man, I've been watching this team, and they have been looking so much better than they did in the past. And they've been actually taking down a number of the top teams. They most recently beat IG. They beat Vici Gaming before in a best of one in Star Series. Overall, the record is losing to Vici Gaming. I believe the record post-TI is like 2-1 or something like that. And you should probably expect Vici Gaming to walk away with a win here, but HGT, if they continue to kind of make the improvements that they have in the last week and a half to 2 weeks, this could actually be one of your tier one teams. They've taken down IG, they've taken down LGD, all the amateur teams they've beaten. So it just goes to show that this team has been making some big improvements, and who knows, maybe we'll see an upset here in this best of three. We already have the draft underway. Viper, Centaur, Warrunner, and the Wisp is going to be picked up here by
Vici Gaming's turn to pick.
By Vici Gaming, they're immediately going to pick up a Tiny to go with it. HGT rapid firing back with their draft. They went ahead with the Death Prophet Tidehunter. We took a while for the bans, but the second set of picks went by so fast. Ancient Apparition and Sand King is going to be their duo support. So big AoE, incredible team fight. Should be pretty strong versus the Wisp Tiny. Sand King, any line stuns are usually pretty good versus Tiny Wisp. You have a good chance of being able to catch out both of them. HGT do have that big AoE team fight from the Tidehunter as well to be able to set up easy Ice Blast or Epicenter combinations. So in general, we're looking at a lot of team fight and some decent pushing power from Death Prophet. But Vici Gaming have kind of drafted themselves the best possible thing they can do against this kind of team fight push strat, which is get better late game and get good split push. That is really going to be threatening towers, and that's through the Tiny and Wisp combination. Now, they're still going to have enough team fight that they can contest HGT. When HGT starts going for some of these, maybe not necessarily the tier ones, we'll see how the laning phase goes. That's really what it comes down to. But depending on the laning phase, Vici Gaming may be able to contest tier ones going down. If not, they'll contest tier twos going down with the Wisp Tiny joining them. But at the same time, they still have split pushing options, which is what we really need to see oftentimes when you're dealing with this much straightforward go, 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 push, 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 fight, fight, fight. Now, HGT don't actually have that strong a laning phase, which is another thing that Vici Gaming could exploit. And looks like we're going to DC out here. Bristleback was banned away by Vici Gaming, one of the tougher team fight heroes that are being run with a lot of push strats right now. Pretty popular in China as a 4-5 pickup. But it would have been a one position Bristleback, which I guess I could see happening here, but can't quite totally agree with that. And we'll just reconnect real quick. I also like the fact that HGT went ahead and banned away the Drow Ranger, knowing they're like, Vici Gaming, man, they crushed people with that Drow Ranger before. So They wanted to make sure there wasn't going to be a Visage Drown Ranger. Instead, we have a different combination, though, which is just as potent, just as strong as Split Push, which is the Wisp Tiny. And now they're going to pair it with the Lich. So we have dual lanes that are going to be coming up, which should be the Lich Centaur, Tiny Wisp, and then the Viper as our solo. Slark is going to be grabbed by HGT, and it's a pretty common pickup, though I'm not too convinced about it because we do have a couple of AoE stuns, Avalanche, as well as a Centaur's Hoof Stomp. That can be a little bit disruptive for a Slark. But Slark is, in general, a pretty valued carry right now, I would say, in the Chinese scene. Don't see him nearly as much in the Western scene, but Slark still has a lot of value. He's a good, strong, mid-game team fighter, snowballing hero, and also gives you a lot of late-game possibilities. Not necessarily more late-game viability than a Tiny, that's for sure, especially the Tiny Wisp, but still. Does give them some sort of late game possibilities here. And as we see, Black is actually going to be playing the Centaur, and Ice will be playing that Tiny. So interesting. I wonder how they're going to be laning this, though, because we do have the.
Prepare. Wait, where's my.
Oh, dear. All right. Get rid of Toby. Anyway, I'm expecting this going to be a Centaur Lich offlane, and then to have the what did Toby do to my overlay? Anyway, Centaur Lich is our offlane, the Tiny Wisp as our mid, and then we're just left with a solo safe lane Viper. HGT going in for a very early gank here. Trying to invade the enemy jungle. They're also going to be blocking away the hard camp here, which is pretty common for the Wisp to try and farm up. And FY should be our first blood here with the Chilling Touch going down. They don't have a tether just yet, but he barely gets himself away before the right clicks go in. And they just didn't have any extra stuns. And HGT will fail to get that first blood. They do a lot of damage to the Wisp, but he'll just run back to base. And that'll be pretty simple for him. So HGT in response, how are they going to be dealing with the dual lane? I'm presuming they're just still going to keep the Death Prophet in the mid and still run with the defensive tri-lane with the Tidehunter. I don't know. You can't actually put the Tidehunter up against the Viper 1v1 in the off lane. So they kind of have to give him some support. I guess that's going to come through the Ancient Apparition. I'm really not convinced that's going to be enough. I feel like VG Gaming have drafted themselves much more superior lane. And that is, in my opinion, the most important part of this whole entire laning phase. Death Prophet should be pretty good versus the dual lanes, but the issue is not necessarily the how Death Prophet is going to do in this matchup. It's more like the fact that the Wisp Tiny should be able to do pretty well, though they are going to be held up by the fact that this camp is blocked out, which is usually how the Wisp really gets the Tiny a lot of extra farm. So his mid presence is kind of disrupted by that fact. We'll see whether or not they can bring out some early counters. They do already have a bottle coming out. Bottom lane, they're going to go on Fenrir, and that's going to be your first blood. ZSMJ finds the opening here on the Lich. And they get exactly what they needed, which was to really crush that dual lane. Because Icy is not going to have a great time here. 1v1 up against a Viper. I mean, any melee is going to suffer, but Tidehunter is Anchor Smash. Doesn't really help you out. Viper should never get hit by that. And your Kraken Shell is only going to be able to do so much for you. Don't worry. We caught first blood. We're waking up bit by bit. I said morning in the introduction because it is morning for me. As I just came in. Toby had a lot of extra work to do, so I went ahead and came in to cover Cinecup for him. And here we are. Icy. Well, he's in melee. I mean, if any engagement... It goes well for the Tidehunter against the Viper. It's when you round the corner and you're in melee range of him. Oh, no. Tiny Wisp combination ends up popping the Death Prophet here. I said Death Prophet should do pretty well against the Death Prophet is one of the better heroes to go up against dual lanes, but still ends up getting caught. Obviously, you can't afford to be caught by the combination, and you need to try and keep yourself at full health at all times, but Death Prophet just spams out, and hitting more than one hero just makes the Crypt Swarm that much more valuable in lane. So really thought he should have been able to live through this just fine. You can see the Crypt Swarm already harassing Ice back. Of course, the advantage being that the bottle, FY, that's why he's currently trying to tank up creeps, is that he wants to use this regen to heal Ice up. So, doing what they can. Slark is definitely going to be a very big threat here. They do need to start stacking, though. Have they? Yeah, they've already got one stack here. They need to continue this, though, for the Sand King to pick up a fast Blink Dagger. I think that's their greatest hope, is going like double Blinks on the Slark as well as the Sand King. If they can get Tidehunter a Blink Dagger as well, he seems to be doing pretty well at this offlane so far. I mean, honestly, he's ahead in CS against a Viper, and he hasn't died yet. Part of this is because he brought himself a lot of extra regen and is also got himself a really early set of boots, which is really making sure that he's not getting harassed overly. But yeah, it's going to be all about the mid-game aggression here for HGT and whether or not they can pick off these heroes and keep down the Tiny before he gets up that Aghanim Scepter and all his extra farming items. They're going to go for Kaka here. They need to be able to get these teleports in. Kaka going to be tossed back to the west. Nicely played. They still need a little bit of extra damage, though. Kaka, one last right click, and they get him. Really need to have teleports on these supports. They can't afford to just let them dive into tier 1 towers like that. It's very, very silly. I mean, especially seeing as they have the extra money here. They've already upgraded the courier. There's nothing else they really need right now. Just having a teleport can do so much against that Tiny with dual lane. And that's part of the reason, like, Death Prophet is good versus dual lanes. But you always have to expect that they're going to try and go for a dive. As long as you play your positioning right, that dive should turn detrimental to the enemy team. Like, they shouldn't actually be able to pull off a dive like that and not be punished severely for it. Like, even if they do kill you, you should at least get one kill in return and have control of the lane from there. So I really disagree with the fact that supports do not have those early teleports. But they are going to try and go for a gank here on Ice. The stun is actually going to be dodged by the Bro Strike. Ice is in some serious trouble. Has that extra movement speed, though. Right click. They need another one. Kaka trying to get in range of the Crypt Swarm. Not quite enough. Doesn't quite catch him. And now he's going to turn on to FY. Ice still sticking around, trying to help out his Wisp. Tethers up in a second. He'll just get himself away. And Ice, after a bit of heal from the bottom, will now try and turn this one around. And in the bottom lane, they catch out ZSMJ, which is huge. HGT now are just getting really messed up. They're going to go for Kaka here, missing the Burrow Strike. Kaka, the Wisp Balls, will finish him off. Ice, just keeps on rolling through. Now going to go for Ancient Apparition as well, diving into the towers. And FY Ice have just almost single-handedly won the game. I mean, the fact that Black and Fenrir got a kill on this Slark is really good for them. Congrats. But this dual lane is crushing HGT so hard, this could be like a 20-minute GG. From the way this is going, their push grant, like, it's all about the mid-game here for HGT, but if they end up losing the laning phase so hard like this that they can't actually get a good mid-game, and you have a really farm Tiny Wisp combination that can not only beat you in teamfights, but also take down your tier 2s on the side lanes really quickly, this snowball is just going to go so heavily against HGT that heroes like Slark and Death Prophet, they do not work at cold parity or being even at behind in gold. Slark especially, man, is very much the definition, I feel, of a snowball carry. And he has this point in time where all he really needs is a Blink Dagger, and he tries to, and he's really powerful for the next 10 minutes. But if you can't actually finish off those supports with one of your combinations, if you're put in danger by just some of these AoE spells, I don't expect how the Slark is going to be able to have the kind of sustain to lay in enough right-click damage to really threaten the enemy team. Nice little block there from Ice. And they're going to go into the jungle here, looking for Ancient Apparition. They'll catch him. This is going to be no issue whatsoever. However, he will be stunned up. Fenrir coming in. They do see pretty hot. They do get off the Ravage. Anchor Smash going down. They need to be able to finish off Ice. And Icy comes in at the perfect time. Two-man hoof stomp, though. ZSMJ getting low. They need to be able to finish him off. He gets off the ultimate, though. It's going to go for FY. Trying to catch him out. Maybe with the pounce, he can finish him off. He doesn't actually have a pounce up. He went for a split build. And that actually ends up killing him because the Wisp with the spirits was able to finish him off. FY is dominating. And while Ice may have lost his life for that fight, it's well worth it for VG Gaming. Our Lich is soon going to be level 6 as well. The teleport into the middle lane. This is just a level 3 Sand King. The Slark is going to help out a lot, but Kaka leading the charge here is going to be hit by the Avalanche and also clips Sand King, which means that he will not be able to get in range of the Burrow Strike. That level 1 Burrow Strike is so difficult to work with. It's damn near impossible. And they could have actually blocked out this hard camp, but this ward doesn't block it. It just shows what they're doing. So they're actually going to try and take advantage, and that's because Relocate is already up. They're going to go for the Ancient Apparition here. And what can he do? He's going to try and turn this around, but Black is already here on the other side. They're actually going to go for ZSMJ next, but they don't have enough to catch him. And they'll just go right back to the middle lane and continue farming. That kind of aggressive vision. And now, like, they see Pretty Hot doing this right now. They're probably going to rotate in and try and put a stop to that. And that could be another free kill. Rather big stack from here as well, Death Prophet. Stacking up the hard camp is something that's very common for the Radiant side Death Prophet. See Ice trying to see if he can catch one of those supports. Oh, they know the camp is low. Let's go ahead and pop it. This is getting disgusting now. They're just taking not only hero kills everywhere, but now they're taking HGT's recovery farm. They actually managed to somehow get this stack. I don't even know what HGT could do from there. Ultimate going off. That looks like it was just to save the top lane Viper, who was attempted gank from ZSMJ. Isn't going to be able to catch him out. Ice and FY, the death squad here. Deep into the enemy jungle. Ridian's going to stun up Wiz. They do get a double avalanche there. And now Kaka's getting low, but Ice doesn't have any follow-up damage. ZSMJ is going to be able to get a secondary kill as Icy joins him. And five heroes here in the middle lane. I mean, when you show yourself for so long there, in that so deep in the enemy side of the jungle, you got to expect some rotation. So FY and Ice getting a bit too aggressive and really just too greedy, thinking that they were going to be able to somehow steal that stack. Blink Dagger already up for Black Centaur War Runner. And FY, did he actually relocate just to see if he could steal some of this experience? Because if so, he failed pretty miserably. Maybe he just didn't bring Ice in time or something. And we've been so focused on the tiny Wisp combination that we haven't really looked at some of the other heroes. Look at Super's farm. Look at his CS. In that top left corner. 65-9. That's like not missing a single CS. Like you 7Xing is pretty much perfect CS. He's also got another 9 denies. That's incredibly good, especially since he was ganked up at one point in time. The middle lane, they do try and put some aggression on Akaka, won't be able to catch him out. And the funny part is, he's doing that well in CS, and he's actually not that far ahead of his two other cores, who are doing very well because they've gotten kills. All these hero kills. Black and FY will make sure that that ward is denied.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Good awareness from HGT, but they already been caught out enough by the rotations here from the side of VG Gaming. That ward was kind of worth it for them. Mid lane, Ravage is going to go off. They're going to try and go for Ice. Anchor smash, but a beautiful relocate from FY will save. And that's now Kaka using his exorcism. And the end result is really nothing. In fact, you see with the Lich already here, they're going to return with the Wisp timing. And they have no problem trying to go for another team fight here. ZSMJ will try and push in the bottom lane. But sure enough, this tier 1 tower will go down. Black Was looking for a blink there, but got hit by the Crimson One before he could blink.
Middle tower has fallen.
And claiming the top tier 1 tower, claiming the middle tier 1 tower, and next up is the bottom tier 1 tower. They've already got themselves a really big gold lead. I mean, when the Wisp is rivaling the Tidehunter and the Death Prophet for farm, you know you got some serious issues. So yeah, the Wisp Tiny have just given so much room for Black Centaur and Super's Viper to be able to farm up that they are massively ahead. And it's going to continue in situations like this. Chain Frost bounces out. That was a very optimistic gank there from the two of them. FY, meanwhile, they have to try and keep up some vision that isn't quite as obvious, because I'm betting Vici Gaming are going to invest in a good amount of counter wards here, as their rotations are really what's killing HGT. And if they could just limit the vision from the side of Hyper Glory team, they'll just
Radiant's
continue to
tower is under
to find those openings to turn pickoffs into towers. FY bouncing away is ZSMJ is beginning to catch up here. FY, I mean, it was going to be such a deep dive. Slark can't possibly go for that. Drums, meanwhile, finished up on Ice. You already had an Ogre Club before that, so expect a pretty fast Aghanim, especially at the rate that these towers are beginning to fall. Super already has a mech. Our Centaur can start building into a pipe if he wants to. He already has his Blink Dagger. At least a cloak would be nice. You've got a lot of magic damage on the side of HGT. Blink Dagger is almost finished here from the Sand King, but
Dire's top tower is under attack.
This last couple hundred gold is going to be tough for him to find, especially with the Wisp Tiny taking over the jungle. Ice. Finds Pretty Hawk, gets the Avalanche Toss combination, and yeah, that last couple hundred gold now turns into 500 more gold. After that kill, Ice, looking to catch up with Kaka here, the slight slow from the Ancient Apparition. Ice, still keeping in pace here. But the Death Prophet, one of the faster heroes in the game. Really surprising. Oh, look at this relocate with the two-man hoofstomp, follow-up double edge, and the stampede on top of it. They kill both the Slark as well as the Tidehunter. And one very well-executed initiation from Black. And there it is, Wisp now ahead of the Slark. Point booster picked up by Kaka. I don't really know what he's going to build with this. I mean, this is certainly not a Bloodstone game, in my opinion. Don't really see how that's going to work out for them. Death Prophet is going to die a bunch and lose all of his charges. They dive into the top lane. Ancient Apparition is a guaranteed kill. A ZSMJ with the toss back might be able to get him, but a nice little pounce over the cliff. And he will be able to get himself away. Blink Dagger's picked up by the Sand King. They're going to need the most beautiful execution of their life. They don't have Ice Blast. Never mind. They can't even win the fight. Not without Ice Blast. Like, how? How are they possibly going to do that? Icy caught out. Black with a little bit of stampede. Slowed down, body blocking him as much as possible. Icy still has a Ravage, but doesn't want to blow it defensively. Now Kaka comes in with the Exorcism. Nice little three-man bro strike, but these heroes just aren't taking any damage. Now the Chain Frost bounces around, continues to hit the Ancient Apparition on the side. Super held in place, and with ZSMJ as well as Kaka targeting him, he will be able to get that one kill, but it's going to be at the cost of both of their lives. Burrow strike to the side. Looks like our Sand King's also going to be caught as Sand King toss. Yep. It's going to be the Wisp Balls. And hey, look at that. 16-minute GG before the 20-minute. What do you know? 5-17. 16-minute GG call. And Vici Gaming continue to steamroll through the Chinese scene, man. Holy crap. So well played by Vici Gaming. They win this first game in the best of three in the upper bracket of the Cena Cup. Stick around, guys. Game two coming up in just a few minutes.